Here's a fun fact for you. 98% of app spending is made with in-app purchases. Also, ordinary iMessage apps or sticker apps do not have in-app purchases in them. But with RMessage, you can let users download your app for free, try out some of your stickers, and then pay for extra stickers with in-app purchases. Let's make money with some sticker packs. So let's take a look at RMessage, the only iMessage extension with in-app purchases. I'm running this on the simulator, so this is how it actually looks like when we first open it up. Also, we may choose to have different sizes of icons right over there. So the stickers will accommodate their sizes accordingly. And then also we can just search for anything that we want on the stickers. We can cancel that out. Also, we may favorite one of those stickers. Let's just go back. So now if we just search only through our favorited stickers, you will see that there they are. Now, finally, what we can do is have an in-app purchase. So if we click on the lock icon, then we click on unlock, and then we will be taken to the main application where we can unlock all the stickers. Also, here we have all the locked stickers. Now, let's just unlock the stickers. And of course, because I have already done this, it's just automatically saying you have unlocked all the stickers. But this is actually in a purchase that you are going to take. Let me just show you some screenshots of that. So here is some of the great screenshots of the application. And finally, here we have our purchase of unlocked. And of course, you are all set up successfully. And this is what we are going to set up today. I'm going to show you how easy it is to set up. And let's just scroll all the way up and let's see. Step one. So step one is to basically create a new app if you choose to and add an iMessage app extension to it. Now, if you prefer to use the actual demo application, then you can skip step one. RMessage container and RMessage shared and RMessage extension are already dragged and dropped in. So these two should be inside the main application and the extension, RMessage extension, should be inside your extension. So what you are going to get under the resources, it's right over here. By the way, you can take a look at RMessage at store.rebeloper.com/RMessage. Yes. So this is how it looks like. So we have our container, our shared one. And when you drag and drop your shared one, make sure that you select both of them. So right over here, if you just go under setup, you make sure the target membership is also on the main app and the extension. Of course, on the RMessage extension, that's only for the extension. And the container is only for the container app. Also, make sure that you kind of override or just simply delete the messages view controller that comes from the default extension, and you just replace it with this one. Okay, so how to set this up? Let's just go back to our setup right over here. So we drag and drop our folders. Now we want to set up app groups because our extension needs to communicate with the main application because we are making the in-app purchase inside our main application. So let me just show you how that's done. You just go under signing and capabilities, and right over here, currently it's added, but if you don't have app groups enabled, then what you want to do is just go ahead and click on the plus capability and just search for app groups. And then what you want to do is add group.com.rebeloper.rmessage. That's my bundle identifier. Basically, you should use your own bundle identifier and then do the same for the extension also. Finally, what you want to do is go under the setup and make sure that you set up the suite name under app group for the same string. Now the key is locked, make sure that you just leave it as is. If you change it during versions, then all of your users will be locked out from their in-app purchases. So please, please don't do that. Just leave it as locked. Okay, so what is our next step? We have set up our app groups so we can communicate the in-app purchase between the main application and the extension. And then you want to add your stickers. Now, how do we add our stickers? Well, you just go under RMessage Share and then stickers, and you just add in your stickers. Now, we support PNG, APNG, GIFs, GIF, JPEG. So here is how we set this up under the setup. We are going to take a look at that in just a second. For now, you just drag and drop all of your stickers right over here as simple files, not in the assets folder. You just drag and drop your app icon there, but as separate files. Let's take a look at step number four, adding your in-app purchase ID to unlock the locked stickers. So how would we do that? Let's just go back to our Xcode project again. Well, first of all, you see we have StoreKit Pro enabling in-app purchases for this application. What you want to do is under StoreKit Pro setup, make sure that you create a unique ID. Now, I usually use my bundle identifier and plus the dot unlock. This could be any string. Make sure that it's unique. And basically, that's it. Finally, what you want to do is under, if you want to test this inside Xcode, then you want to go to products and then create unlock in-app purchase with the price. And so basically this is for local testing. And if you did set this up, what you want to do is go under RMessage, so the main app, and then edit manage schemes. Let's see, oh, it should have been edit scheme. So let's just go under edit scheme, and the StoreKit configuration should be our products.StoreKit. So make sure that you select this. As you can see, it had some red outline, but make sure that you select that. You don't have to do anything else. It's under run, options, and StoreKit configuration. Okay, so now that you have set up your in-app purchase, let's take a look at our final step, and that is the setup file where we can customize quite a lot of things. So let's take a look at the setup file. It's under RMessage Shared, setup. And let me just move this out of the way so we can see it better. So we talked about the app group. That's how we just connect our extension to the main application. So we know that, okay, did we make that in-app purchase or not? And then we have here an array of stickers. So you did add your actual images there, but now you want to create this array with their name, type, and search phrase, because of course we are going to search through that in the expanded mode. And basically, that's it. If you want to make this in-app purchase not free, then make sure that you set is free to false. Otherwise, is free will be set to true. So whatever in a sticker you want to set to be logged, then make sure that you set is free to false. And there you have it. You have an array of stickers. Now there's a lot more customization options right over here. For example, the background. You can set a background color. Currently, it's a clear color. Now we have our columns. What type of columns do you want to use? Can they select the column changer? If they can, then you say, may set the true to can select. What is the initial index for the columns? And here we have our values. Now you want to add in grid items. So here we will have two columns, three, and so forth. Of course, you may edit this array of values. It might have only two of them. So if I delete these, it's just perfectly fine. Okay. Also, you just leave it as one or whatever. This is for the columns. Now, we also have a button that will enable the columns. You can customize this. We have a system name, color, and corner radius for it. Also, you can customize the lock on the stickers. You may have a sticker opacity, system name for the actual lock, a font, a color, and the alert. What pops up? Well, basically the string values of the alert, the title, message, cancel button title, and unlock button title. Now, we also have a swipe tutorial. If you recall, we can swipe down on the search functionality so the user can, search the stickers. This is what it's going to be displaying once you swipe it down, after you hit got it, you know, the button, then this swipe tutorial will not be shown at all. Now here are some miscellaneous: shows header in compact mode, shows title in compact mode, custom title in compact mode, so you just add in your custom title. You can leave it as an empty string if you want to display the bundle display name, or and also the same goes for the custom title in the expanded mode. No start stickers text, so if you don't have any start stickers, then this text will pop up. Copyright text, showing the version, shows scoring indicators, can start stickers. So all of these are really a great way to customize to your needs. Also, there's a container ad, as you saw, where we buy our in-app purchase. It has a title, a subtitle, columns for, you know, the stickers, an unlock button title, restore purchases button, and an unlock message. And basically, that's it. If you want to make your application or your sticker pack really, really like custom, then you can do this right over here. Now, you can make your purchase and just take a look at the screenshots. They are really, really nice. Also works really well in dark mode. As you can see, it's cool. So it's 100% documented. We have an Xcode project. And of course, you have iOS 16 version. Now the iOS 15 version, there's another video on the documentation for that. But all of them had the code and the resources and a video documentation. Again, it's at store.rebeloper.com/rmessage. Now you saw that RMessage is powered by StoreKit Pro. If you're interested in a more fine detailed way of how to use in-app purchases in your application, be it consumables, non-consumable, in-app purchases, or auto-renewable subscriptions, go ahead and check out StoreKit Pro. The video is right over here.